Lausanne in Switzerland, the headquarters of FISU, where the International Federation fixes its goals for the coming year. After last year's Universiades, 2014 is the year of the World Championships, and FISU is organizing 29 of them in 22 countries around the world, including new ones in the Middle East and Asia.
It's excellent because historically, World University Championships have been organized in Europe. Approximately 70% of the events were always in Europe. And it's interesting for us to have events that are now, people are asking us for events that are outside of Europe. For the first time, we are taking floorball, for example, which is a very predominantly European sport, is for the first time going abroad. It's going to Singapore. We have events that are being asked outside of Europe, which is also particularly important for us as an international federation. We want to have a global reach.
On va avoir des championnats du monde de...
Yes, we have the University World Championships, which I believe are going to be of a higher standard than they have been up to now, both in terms of organization
and in terms of participation.
We have the World Championships that are, of course, very diverse. We've tried to host new sports.
And
then there are the special events, because we're obliged to anticipate the future.
Parce que on est obligé d'anticiper sur l'avenir.
Five countries are holding a world championship for the first time. It's Singapore for floorball, Belarus for canoeing sprint, India and squash, the United Arab Emirates are hosting shooting, and woodball goes to Malaysia.
Our program now has approximately 40 sports. It is, from a participation perspective, it is interesting because more students are able to do more sports. So maybe before there was a very small program, in the meantime it has grown. And students that before they would only compete at a local level, now they can do their tournaments at an international level. They can be playing their specific sport with teams coming in from other countries from all over the world.
Some world championships will involve close to 700 student athletes. The demand is such that several countries may compete for the same event.
And it's interesting to see countries that traditionally would not organize one event, but they're very interested. A very good example will be this year we're going to have the first World University Championship in American football, and the country that's hosting it is Sweden, which probably would not be the very first country that would come to mind, but I can tell you at the same time that they are doing an absolutely amazing job. They're going to prepare an event which I am very sure that anybody who participates in that event will not be disappointed at all.
FISU objectives: to promote member countries, but also to promote sports in new countries, like Singapore.
I'm very excited about Singapore because we're taking an European sport into an Asian region, and this is generating so much interest in that region. Surrounding countries, like not relatively close, but even New Zealand, Australia, Malaysia, Thailand, they're very interested, they want to participate. This is excellent because we're facilitating the development of the sport as well. And this is also a key aspect for FISU, particularly for the World Championships, for us to help develop certain sports as well.
FISU wants to open new avenues for its sports, like its beach sports festival and basketball 3-on-3 in Brazil, a special sports event. So why is FISU so apparently frenetic?
Well, you know, the
world is changing very quickly. And universities are changing extremely quickly. Students are zappers. So student sports have to be ready for anything that may happen in the future. And we have to prepare for it.
Et donc on prépare ça.
In March, Uganda will open the season with the 320th FISU World Championships. It'll be cross-country, and campus will be there. Every year, young athletes compete in France in the first international competition of their career, the Tennis Masters U, in just a moment.